So I'm still plugging away on this landscape lighting project, or garden lighting as I would call it, and I'm using these Wiska boxes at the bottom of each fence post that I'm mounting a light on to make the electrical connection to the fitting. Now, obviously in the past when perhaps we were terminating an armoured cable into a plastic enclosure, we'd have to, you know, put the gland in first, and then we'd have to put a lock nut in, and then we'd have to put a banjo, earthing ring, sorry Gary, and then finally another lock nut, and try to terminate a fly lead onto the banjo, maybe bend it up a bit to get the screw in. In short, an absolute pain. Now, of course, we could use an earthing nut or a piranha nut in a plastic enclosure, and that takes some of the challenge away. However, because these adaptable boxes from Wiska are so brilliantly small, I think you'd struggle to fit either of those in here. So Wiska have come up with another solution, the earth clamp bar. It's this solid piece of brass which just sits inside this box, the 308 box. And as you can see here, it's been machined on the back in order to fit around all the mouldings of the plastic in there. It sits in there really nicely. There's a little bit of flexibility of movement, but it's there ready to receive the armored cable glands. Now, I'm sure that the more eagle-eyed among you will look at that and think, well, how am I going to tighten up the lock nut onto it when there's not enough room to spin it around in there? Now, this may be one of those times when we have to kind of fight against all of those ingrained experiences and instincts when I say that you don't actually need a lock nut inside here, okay? So let's just think about the purpose of the lock nut normally. What does it do? Well, it serves two purposes, doesn't it? It holds the gland mechanically into whatever you're connecting to, and when it's tight, it forms part of the electrical connection between the armoring, the gland, and the banjo. Well, the Wiska box actually provides the mechanical connection for the gland because it has a threaded connection here. And when you do up this little brass screw on the front of the earth clamp bar here, you can see it locks onto the threads of the gland and it locks it into place, which gives it that all important electrical connection for your CPCs. So both of those functions of the lock nut are carried out in other ways. There's also another screw on the top here that allows you to either run a fly lead out to the terminals that clip into the Wiska box, or as I'm going to do on this one, just connect your CPC directly onto there. Of course, it's perfect here because I've got an SWA coming in and going out. Now, one of the main reasons that I wanted to make this video was to answer a question that I couldn't find anywhere else when I was looking, and that is, can I use this earth clamp bar in Wiska's smaller version of this box? Now, Wiska do a few different versions of this clamp to fit into different boxes, but I couldn't find a specific one for this smaller box. Maybe no one's expecting you to terminate armoured into a small box like this, but a small armoured shouldn't cause too much trouble with the connections inside there. It looked from all the promotional material that I could find that it should fit in there. The form factor of the smaller box looks almost as if the bigger box has just been cut in half. So let's have a look at it. It seems that the clamp sits inside there quite neatly, but what I found earlier is that when I tried to do up two armoured cable glands into here, one of them goes in absolutely fine, no problem, but then when you try and put the next one in, it actually won't fit in there. It will not screw up into the fitting. The holes are just ever so slightly misaligned. So when I try and put that second one in, it's just ever so slightly out, so it just doesn't fit in there. So that's answered my question. This earth clamp bar is not designed to be used in the smaller box, so if you've ever wondered that, hopefully now you know the answer. Now, you may have noticed I'm using storm glands here, so please check out the video that I've made on those as well. But while I've got you, let's just have a quick look at some of the other features of this box. It can either be fixed directly to a surface using the screw holes in the corners, or it also comes with this little bracket on the back that can also be fixed in place, and then the box just sort of snaps onto it there. But whichever method you use to fix it, there's no holes into the box itself, which really helps to maintain the IP ratings on here. Then inside, you've got this little kind of connector block, which can be mounted in one of about 8 different ways inside here. And there's just such attention to detail inside here, even to the point where the plastic around the holes is made of a different material to that surrounding it to improve the grip of the connector block inside there. And once you've got this connector block in place, and maybe you want to make the connections easier to access, you can actually unclip the top of the connector block from the holder there. That's really good, isn't it? And of course, finally, the lid is secured just by using these quarter turn fixings, which just lock it into place. So there we go. We've got the Wiska box and the earth clamp bar that sits inside there and makes electricians' lives easier. And here at eFIXX, we like that. Thank you very much for watching.